بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ما بعد. All praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the opportunity to find ourselves and give us the opportunity to come to His house. This is a blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal. We ask Allah to accept our effort. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those people who have been blessed. May all the blessings of this day, Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And we ask Allah to grant us the khair of this day and protect us from the evil. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. In continuation with our discussion regarding asceticism and zuhud, we started the book of Imam Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed him with many qualities, and he himself was inspired by many of the teachings and sayings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah azza wa jal has given this human being all the things that he has, and then Allah azza wa jal has brought different situations upon different things. So a person reflects upon it and he tries to utilize the benefit time that Allah Azza wa Jalla has given him. Onto that, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that take advantage of five things before the arrival of five things. اغتنم خمسا قبل خمسا. Number one is شبابك قبل هرمك. It's your youth age before you become old. When a person is youth, he is young, he's able to do a lot of things. He has a lot of energy inside him, a lot of thinking he can do. Now, there is two ways to do this. Number one is to invest your prime time into those things which will not bring any benefit to you in the life of your after. And number two is to invest in those avenues in which that you are able to gain maximum benefit when you depart from this. Well, a person works throughout his entire life so that he can have a peaceful retirement, right? And he can have a peaceful time when he retires. But no one knows that this person will live to that time or not. No one knows that he will be seeing that retirement that he's looking for by working so hard and sacrificing so many things. So this world is very short and you don't know when you're going to pass. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the opportunity that as long as we are living and we are able to do things, every action, every amal that we do, Allah azza wa jal will give us compensation for it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the person who is punctual in doing some good deed and due to illness he is not able to do them anymore, Allah will continue to reward him as if he is doing it when he was okay and when he was sound and healthy. So this is a blessing of Allah. When Allah Azza wa Jal has given us the opportunity, for example, person is healthy, he comes to the masjid five times a day. He performs every salah of his in the masjid. Then he becomes sick and he's not able to come anymore. So while he is praying at his house, Allah still gives him the reward of praying in the masjid. Why? Because when he had the help, he had means, he did what he was supposed to do. And with every action of an individual, whatever seed you put in during your prime time, Allah will continue to give you a reward if you're not able to do so because of your health. Number two, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, صِحَّتَكَ قَبْلَ سُقْمِكَ. Your health before you become sick. When a person becomes sick, he's not able to do a lot of things. And same, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the person who is punctual in doing good actions while he's healthy, when he becomes sick, Allah will continue to give him reward of what he was doing while he was healthy. So this is also a very great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah has given health to an individual and he invests in something that is beneficial for him in akhirah. غِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقْرِكَ. Your wealth before you lose it. Every individual goes through different situations of life. Sometimes you are affluent in your worldly affairs, and sometimes you are difficult, they have difficulty. When a person, he is wealthy, he has at least this problem taken care of his poverty. The poverty is not there anymore because Allah has given him wealth. So now, this is the time that I can spend in many other good things. Help other individuals out, assist people, give them. And there are numerous narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where Rasul alayhi salam has given description of individual being tested by wealth, and eventually there were those who became successful, and there were those who lost in the test that Allah Azza wa Jal put upon them. So whatever wealth and whatever sufficient amount of provision that Allah has given you, take advantage of that before you go into a situation where you don't have it, and at that time you wish, I wish I could have done this or done that, but at that time it's too late. So the Prophet ﷺ, he is reminding us, these halat, these situations, they come upon human being. Sickness, age, all of these things, this is part of the life of human being. But individual, an intelligent person, is the one who actually invests in the things that will be beneficial for him in the hereafter. Number four is, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, that faragha qabla shughlik, that make sure you take advantage of your free time before you get occupied. Before you get occupied of many things that you're not able to invest and do things that you're supposed to do when you had free time. Time is a very precious gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this individual, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him one of the questions on the Day of Judgment, that how did you spend your time? Every time that goes away from your life, you have to give account of it on the Day of Judgment. You spend it in good action or bad action. We are sitting here, we are listening, all of this time, Allah is giving us reward. So on the Day of Judgment, when our a'mal will be open in front, we will see the benefit of all of this. Today, a person is not able to spend 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes listening to something that might be beneficial for him, right? But tomorrow on the Day of Judgment, every single second, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that every single second that a person has spent without the remembrance of Allah, without learning about the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal, he will regret and he will say that I wish I would have spent even this time in that. And in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that لا يتحسر أهل الجنة, the people of Jannah will never be regretting except for that time that they have spent in this world without the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So time is a very big gift of Allah Azza wa Jal. And then number five is حياتك قبل موتك, your life before your death arrives. And death is something that is for sure for to come upon every individual. No one can escape from it. So Allah has given life. Let's use it for the cause that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us in every avenue of our life. Our life is something that is a gift and amana of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And on the Day of Judgment, Allah will ask of this amana. You know, amana is something that you have to utilize and protect and make sure that it's not taken away by any individual. So our life is an amana that is given to us by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jal has already invested our life into something else. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has purchased the life and the wealth of every believer in exchange of Jannah. So all of this, our life, our wealth, it all belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now Allah is testing us, how are we going to invest and spend these gifts of Allah Azza wa Jal. We ask Allah to give us the realization. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability to utilize these things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has recommended before their contrary situations arrive. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to accept everyone's ibadah and forgive everyone's sin. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Jazakumullahu khairan. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.